Well, good afternoon and welcome back to the shop. As you may have seen on the previous video, we just finished up with the Major County Historical Society threshing bee. So we're back in the shop working on some projects that are long overdue. What we're going to do this afternoon is we're going to go ahead and get this 430 John Deere split in half. It has got a leak on the input shaft of the transmission, I think. That's where I believe it is, because it's dripping out right below the clutch pedal, and it is transmission grease that's leaking out. So it's not going to take us too long to do this. I might go ahead and tell you, I've already drained what oil was in the rock shaft, because the hydraulic lines are going to have to be split. I've pulled the wire back from the rear light. I've got it draped over the steering wheel, and I've got a pair of homemade splitting jacks bolted onto the side. They are nothing more than trailer tongue jacks, but I came across a pretty good deal on those, and I decided to try to make something to see if this would work for me. So this is going to be the first time to use them, so we're going to see how they work. So let's get started. I still have to finish disconnecting the suction line for the hydraulics. This tube runs back and runs into the rock shaft housing, which is also the reservoir for the hydraulic fluid. This tractor has enough leaks. As I said before, we drained what little hydraulic fluid was left in this tractor. I do have a rebuilt rock shaft housing for this tractor, and we may go ahead and try to install that while we've got this tractor apart. So I'm going to get these two bolts disconnected from this flange. This flange right here on this tube, since there's really no pressure on this tube, it's actually suction. It's a cork sleeve, cork ring type affair in there. Not the best type of sealing. I may try to do some V ring type packing on this instead. I'll have to see what's available. I know McMaster Car has some. We'll see. All right, almost have it. Then really, when this is complete here, we'll just have four bolts and we'll be ready to try to get this part. Okay, so there's the flange back. This hydraulic hose here is supposed to be a steel line. It's been replaced years ago with this hydraulic hose, so we'll have to thread it back through. I'll lay those two right there along with the wrench. All right, let me get the jack in position. This jack is going to support the back half of the tractor. So right now, I am just going to slide it in here and come up with it. I'm going to come right up under the drawbar support. I'll be attempting to roll the front half of the tractor forward. I'm going to try to leave the transmission and differential in place, and I'll have some adjustment here by cranking this up and down, or maybe one side or the other. So I think now we're ready to try to get the last four bolts. Sure we are. The last four bolts that mates the torque tube to the transmission. Go ahead and get these. Dropped it. There we go. Lay that up there. I think the top one is a nut on the stud, so that will help us when we're guiding it back together. There's nothing else that really has to come apart. The steering, battery, everything except this wire right here that I've already disconnected will all go forward with the tractor. So that is rainwater. It is leaking out of the, doesn't have any oil in it. It must have just been, well, it's got a little bit of oil with it, but I can't tell if that's, it shouldn't be in the transmission. I've changed the transmission fluid in the last couple of months, and it did have a milky consistency to it when I did, but this tractor hadn't been outside since, so I don't know if it's just a collection of rainwater before that or what, but it definitely is. Okay, we got one more. Okay, so I can see that it's already started to split at the bottom. So we're going to crank this up right here. Come over to the other side. Do that as well. Might be a little bit high, but we'll see. Go ahead and get this nut off and we can kind of gauge where we're at. Oh, must have tightened that up. Nut on this stud is enclosed beneath this steering bolster and the battery box, so it's not room for a ratchet or anything else. We just have to get it the old-fashioned way. All right. Okay, we are started apart. I'm going to okay. Got a little bit of I'm gonna have to get a pry bar here just a bit. Okay, let me get one. What I want to make sure and try to do is keep these input shafts inside of the torque tube. The clutch assembly is clear up here to the front, and you've got this gap between here and that that's called the torque tube or the center frame or whatever. But there's shafts that run from the input of the clutch to the input of the transmission, and usually if they do come out up in the forward end, you can get them back in, but you certainly don't want to push the clutch pedal and try to do that, or your clutch disc will fall out of alignment. So we're going to do our best to keep it in forward and go from there. All right. Let me see here. Well, we have a split. Let me see if I can rock. Not very well. Oh, yep. That's a good thing I had the bucket there, because I just broke loose the suction line on the hydraulics, so we are leaking into the bucket. So that was a good thing. Still have this hose that is well, it looks like we've got the light here, and it looks like that the input shafts are coming, or they are staying with the transmission, which is not exactly what I had planned. But let me That's better. Okay, so we're gonna come on out with it. Sure enough. Okay. The stands are working well as far as that goes, but as I stated, I would sure rather have had those stay with the clutch, but we'll go ahead and roll this on forward. Long string of silicone rubber right there. I changed this torque tube on this tractor sometime I believe in the 90s it had been broken and brazed together. So that I must have siliconed it at that time. So, all right. So we are, let me see if I can get this. I've got my hydraulic hose hung up right here. Outer covering is cracked and split, and I lost the cap right there again. I have to get another one. But let me grab some gloves. So we are going to, I believe this is the seal right here that is causing me issues. Right here. This input shaft seal. Either that or I have a leak somewhere. This housing right here on the front of this transmission houses the PTO gear train. This outside tube, as you'll see here in just a minute, I'm gonna get in here and get this off, but there's actually two drive lines that are in the 430, the inside one is transmitting the power from the engine to the transmission. This outside tube is from the secondary clutch that powers this piece right here, which is the independent power takeoff. So there's actually shaft within a shaft. And we'll see if, that's not coming out that way. Oh. Let me see if I can get that. Get a chisel wedged in there and tap that out. That may be, I believe that might be pinned right there. I believe it is. I believe there's a pin through there. Let me get some, a little bit of cleaner. Does look like a pin right there. So if that's the case, maybe it might come out. Might be. I do know that that tube is out of the PTO clutch for sure. So we'll have to work at getting that back. Well, I may see if I can go ahead and drive that pin out. That is a part of a roll pin. So let's see what we're gonna do now. Go, and we are out. We are falling out. So, yes, but this is what I was explaining to you before. This shaft right here is the primary power transmission shaft from the engine to the transition, a transmission. This will be your first clutch in the dual clutch setup. Then this shaft goes on the outside of that one, and this is the one that actually delivers the independent power takeoff. So there's always two shafts there that you have to deal with. So hopefully we can get them back into the transmission without too much effort. So let me go ahead and slip this tractor. It's about as far forward as I can get it, but those trailer jacks are working very well. They let me just raise that up and balance that. So anyway, that's where we are now. We'll give this a look-see to check and see what all we may have wrong here. See if we can find some the source of the leak. We'll get this differential housing balanced between two sets of stands to where we can get the floor jack from out under it, and then we'll go ahead and see what it's going to take to get it repaired. So that's about it for now.